What if we're thinking about climate solution in the wrong way? Carbon emissions from fossil fuels started the climate crisis. So most of our efforts are going towards decarbonization. That makes sense and is the right thing to do. I've been working and volunteering in climate and clean energy for over 20 years. We are not solving the problem fast enough. Temperatures are rising too quickly. We also need solutions that can buy us time for decarbonization. So did you know that methane accounts for about half a degree of global warming right now? About a third of today's global warming? What if we could rapidly reduce methane emissions? Could we slow global warming or even cause the temperature to come back down? Theoretically, it is possible. I don't know if we can do it, but I know we should be reducing methane emissions as fast as possible. There are a lot of sources of methane emissions, and there are a lot of solutions. How do we focus attention and resources towards rapid actions with the biggest impact? Why don't we have a global methane prize? There are a lot of prizes out there already. Do we really need another one? I co-founded the MIT Climate and Energy Prize 16 years ago with Bill Ouellette, and it was one of the first competitions to focus on clean energy. Over 850 teams and thousands of students from around the world have used that competition to accelerate their startups and their climate careers. Alex was a top student in my class, and she won the CEP in 2015. She started IR Labs, which has raised over $200 million to bring optical connectivity to computer chips and can potentially reduce data center energy usage by 50%. So she's now starting her second company called Sphere. And this is a company that provides climate-friendly 401k options for everyone. We know the prize model works. There are other competitions like the Clean Tech Open, several X prizes, and many more. This is not a new idea, but it can have a massive impact on the world and on human life. In 1714, life at sea was so treacherous that captains and merchants pressured the British government to come up with better navigational tools. The government offered the longitude prize, and 63 years later, it was solved. We don't have that long. Napoleon offered a prize to develop a method for preserving food. This led to the method that is used in canning food. That took about 10 years. That's more like it. More recently, in only 8 years, the Ansari X Prize catalyzed the first ever private spaceflight and unleashed the private sector into the space industry. We need to unleash climate innovators into methane and reduce methane emissions and create a trillion-dollar industry in less than 10 years. A ton of methane warms the planet 86 times as much as a ton of CO2 over a 20-year period. And that is the time frame that matters. We have made so much progress on decarbonization, and we will be able to decarbonize in 50 or maybe 30 years. But we cannot wait for decarbonization. Extreme heat is causing weather catastrophes all over the world that anyone can see with their own eyes or if they just watch the news. It's also thawing permafrost. Permafrost contains more carbon than humans have ever emitted. As it thaws, it releases that carbon into the atmosphere as CO2 and methane. And we're not even including these emissions in the Earth systems models, which guide the UN, government, and business leaders. That's a really important point. We really need to include permafrost emissions in the Earth systems models to guide how we're trying to solve the problem, because it's worse than people realize. Methane is so bad that it is better to flare it, set it on fire, and turn it into CO2 than it is to just let it vent into the atmosphere. But most sources of methane emissions are too diluted to set on fire. Only 11% of methane emissions come from oil and gas, where there are high concentrations. We have the technologies to deal with those emissions. Let's put pressure, more pressure, on oil and gas companies to take action to reduce those emissions. But sources like coal mines, cow burps, rice paddies are too dilute and dispersed. This is where we need more innovation. Yes, we should stop coal mining. And yes, we should stop eating cows. But demand is still going up. Let's do what we can to reduce demand, but let's also do what we can to reduce emissions as fast as possible. We can now track methane emissions with ground, air, and space-based sensors. The Global Methane Hub and others are launching initiatives to track those emissions and create platforms to share best practices. There are a lot of solutions out there, as well as new ones coming out of places like MIT. MoxAir has developed a technology which can reduce methane emissions from vented coal mines and cattle feedlots. They do this with a unique catalyst and proprietary reactor design that can be integrated into existing facilities that are currently venting methane. This type of solution can rapidly scale without the material, supply chain, and siting constraints that are limiting the pace of decarbonization. MIT and Stanford are even working on solutions of reducing methane emissions from the atmosphere. Advance market commitments for atmospheric carbon removal have launched a whole new industry and spurred billions of dollars of investments. These agreements are like purchase commitments. They're like power purchase agreements, or PPAs. PPAs are used to finance hundreds of billions of dollars of power projects, and advanced market commitments could do the same thing for methane emissions and methane removal. Several pathways for atmospheric methane removal can be risky, so we do need to make sure we study and understand these risks and create a managed path for these solutions to get to market. Spark Climate Solutions has already started to map these pathways as well as conduct research. Competitions are a proven model that draw funding to the best solutions from around the world. Advanced market commitments and PPAs can be used to finance massive projects. What if we combine these two proven approaches into a new global methane prize? We get the best of both worlds, and we can accelerate solutions at a scale and at a time frame that matters. I'm going to end with an anonymous quote from a very senior climate scientist. Stopping CO2 emissions may stop global warming this century, but reducing methane emissions could actually cool the planet. Thank you.